one. A spiritual physical. You didn't catch that. What kind of physical? Spiritual. Let me see. Which consists of the following. You're gonna have to get an ear exam. According to Romans chapter 10 and verse number 17. So then faith comes about hearing, and hearing comes about the word of God. You're gonna have to get a cardiology exam. I'm sorry, you gotta get a check of the heart. The heart has got to be checked out right to make sure your heart is right. Yes, they said, for that the heart may believe as a righteousness, the mouth confession is made unto the salvation. You're gonna have to get a psychological exam. You got to fall. The mind needs to be checked out. What you talking about? I'm talking about you have to have a change of mind. Luke chapter 13, right now, verse number 3. It's our change in name. But except you repent, you shall likewise work. You better change your mind. Some of you need to get an oral exam. Oh, yeah, you need to get an oral exam. According to Matthew chapter 10, right now, verse number 32 and 33, the Bible says, Whoso therefore shall confess me unto man, him will I confess. Listen. Will I confess also before who? My Father. In other words, you got to get that mouth.
Yes,
you got to open that mouth. Yes, you got to confess the sweet name of Jesus. Oh, yeah. The doctor, let me tell you about the doctor. He ain't too tired of your medication. You know what? Let me tell you something. Every now and then, I might get a little sick. And when I get a little sick, I go where? To the doctor. When I go to the doctor, I tell the lady I'm sick and I don't feel well. So you know what she tell me? She said, wait in the lobby. You're going to see the doctor. I wait in the lobby. She called up and paid my copay. I paid my copay. Then she tell me, the doctor will be out to see you in a minute. So finally, she called me back in the back. The doctor checked me out. He checked my blood pressure. He checked my eye, my ear, and all that stuff. And he said, how you feel? I said, I'm hurt. He said, I'll tell you what you need to do. I'm going to give you something to make you feel better. What you going to give? I'm going to give you some medicine. I'm going to make you feel better. Get out. So he didn't know what he do. He get up, he get his pen, and he write on the pad. He said, go take this to the pharmacy. And he write some stuff that look like that. And I can't understand what the stuff is. And I look at it, and he said, I take this to your pharmacy. So I take it to the pharmacy. I give it to the man behind the wall that I cannot see. I give it to him. He passes it back out to me. I give him some more money. Then for long, you know what they tell me? They said, here, take this here.
Yeah.
Quit making excuses.
Amen.
own soul. Salvation. With fear and with trembling. Don't you let nobody convince you from getting baptized in the water. This thing is on you. Quit that excuse. There were some folks that had a lot of excuses, but God still used them. All you have to do is hear what you want to hear, really well. Noah was a drunk. Abraham was too old. Isaac was a daydreamer. Jacob was a liar. Leah was angry. Joseph was abused. Moses had stuttering problems. Gideon was afraid. Samson had long hair and was a womanizer. Jeremiah and Timothy was too young. David had a fat and was a murderer. Elijah was suicidal. Jonah ran after God. Naomi was a widow. Job was bankrupt. John the Baptist ain't bald. Peter was not quiet. The disciples fell asleep while praying. Martha ran about everything. Mary Magdalene was mad. You know, and the Samaritan woman was divorced more than once. Zacchaeus was too small. Paul was too religious. Timothy had an ulcer. Now, what's your excuse? What's your excuse? If God can use me, folks, He can use you. He can use you. But you need to take out the pots. Are you here today? I'll tell you for a few minutes. Are you here today? And you're not a member of the Church of Christ. You're not a member of the only church that you can read about in the Bible. And when I say this here, I don't say it to be cruel. I'm saying it because it's a fact. If you're not a member of the Church of Christ, what you waiting on? What's your excuse? Why you want this full coverage? You need to get it today. So that when you go out that door, guess what? You can act like a Christian. You be driving along and say, how did you be? You can do it today. Are you here today? You heard the word. Jesus Christ. No, he came into this world. I'm talking about when he was a boy, around about 12 years old. I'm talking about he was in the deck. I'm this little boy. He got started even in the ditch. He lived here for 33 and a half years. They took him out, chummy, to a cross. They hung him between two people. You know, they hung him high, but they didn't realize who they were fooling with. They didn't realize he was the Messiah. He was the stone. He is the Almighty. They didn't know who they were fooling around with. They woke him up there. My Jesus and your Savior. Hold him up there. Hung on the tree 2 feet. You know what? They took him down after they had killed him. They laid him in a tomb. I'm talking about the God that owned everything. They laid him in a tomb that didn't belong to him. Old borrowed tomb. But you know what they did? They rolled a stone in front of the stone. You know, they didn't realize who was in that tomb. They put a stone inside of a stone. Yeah. But one day, they went there and looked for him. I can hear what they say. He is not here. He has risen. Thank God that he rose. Thank God that he ain't down there. Thank God, living God, that we say, he is a living God. Come into effect.